Hi Leo, this is your mid-July 2019 reading. Happy birthday to Leo Sun who are born in July. Leo, we are about to start your season from 22nd of July. But before that, we have a very potent eclipse happening on 16th or 17th of July in your house of work environment and health routines. We are looking at bringing something to fruition, something to completion, something needs to be completed and possibly released that has served its purpose so we can move to bigger and better things. This could be a health habit that we need to kick off and we need to sort of be done with and we start a new health routine here. There could be a particular project at work which is coming to fruition, which is coming to completion, and we need to move on to better projects. Or there might be a structural change in our work environment that requires your attention in the coming 4 weeks. Eclipses typically take 3 to 6 months to completely show their results. But this eclipse, which is happening on 16th of July, is more immediate in nature. Because in my view, the discussion or the karmic event or the fated event related to this eclipse has already happened around 22nd or 23rd of March. So you can look back to 22nd or 23rd of March, what happened with respect to your health environment, with respect to your work routine. Specifically, if you have planets around 24 degree of Leo. So if you are a Leo sun, moon or ascendant, having planets 2 or 3 degrees around 24 degree of Leo, which if you are a Leo sun would be 3 or 4 days around 17th of August born, so I would say around 13th to 20th or 21st of August born, you would feel this very strongly. You will feel this strongly physically in your body and you'll feel this mentally as well. There is an intensity that is created with this eclipse because the messaging of this eclipse is very crisp and clear. This is a Capricorn eclipse, which is linked to clear and structured messaging related to your health, related to your work. It wants us to decide how to proceed forward. It wants us to decide and make a decision in terms of what stays and what goes. Because some work project might be coming to a completion. Certain obligations, this is not just related to work obligations. These are also obligations to our elders. Our duties towards others are highlighted here. Our obligations are highlighted here. How we service others is highlighted here. So our work and assignments, our job, our obligation, our duties towards the elder, the health of the parents, our overall effort that we put, the long-term effort that we put in our work comes to highlight here. Even our teammates, our co-workers, people who work for us, who support us, that come into focus here. Work politics comes into focus here. Work hierarchy comes into focus here. We are looking at figuring out the most efficient way to organize our work in such way that it yields positive results to us, it gives more benefits to us, as well as it helps us take care of our health. Because Leo, with North Node in your house of well-being, you're looking at your health and your self-care becoming very important to your success. You are almost being nudged and asked to take care of yourself when it comes to your physical health here. And the road to success is letting yourself go sometimes to the places where you would not go because you're too busy with the day-to-day. You might be urged to take a little bit of a step back at this point in time and take a view of what's happening right now at work and with your health using your intuition, your hidden talents, your emotional strength to some extent to gauge the current moment and figure out the move forward. You are here to manifest something materially when it comes to your work routines, when it comes to your work assignments, when it comes to setting the right processes, being the person who knows how to set up an organization, who understands how to set up hierarchy, who understands how to set up the best processes possible in the industry. But while doing that, there are certain things that are consuming your attention, your resources, your efforts, which need to be released here. And that might come to light right now. And that sometimes comes to light in a little bit of an unhealthy way, if I may say. So, for example, a health stress can increase at this point in time just to pinpoint where we are taking on too much, where our obligations to others is exceeding our self-care. That might get highlighted over here because we are being brought back to where we should be. We are being brought back to balance. We are being brought back to manifesting in the right way in our career and in our health. Our assets, our health is an asset. It is an asset. And we are being asked to take care of that. So there are certain things at work that can come to light. There could be projects, work assignments that maybe they have served their purpose and we need to move forward with them. And Pluto in your house of day-to-day routine and work gives you this intensity and this intense intuition and power to discriminate between what is of value to you and what is not. It gives you a clarity on what's sort of, if I may say, toxic and what needs to be removed when it comes to your work environment, when it comes to certain projects. This is also the time when certain projects where you have done a lot of work, certain obligations where you've paid your dues, the karma over there might be done and you might see karmic settlement over there. You get the benefits if you've done the work. And if that thing's karma with you is done, that person's karma at work is done with you, or the karma of a co-worker or a person working for you is done with you, this might be the time to let go and move forward from that structure. This is the time when our self-care, our sleep to some extent, becomes very important because you are being asked to go where you normally won't go. You are being asked to look at what kind of fears, what kind of vulnerabilities, what kind of fear of even emotions is stopping you from progressing forward. Because sometimes these are the things that we don't want to deal with as fire sign. I'm a fire sign myself, so being washed with emotions is not my natural mode of working. But being okay sometimes to do that, because that becomes your guiding force in this moment. The emotions become a guiding force at this point in time to lead us to the right direction. More empathy for needy, making room for sort of taking a step back to some extent before your season starts. Thinking things over. Accepting the things that in the past have held you and deciding to work towards releasing them. Releasing certain old routines. Releasing certain work environments. Releasing certain fears and worries in our mind which are bogging us down. Releasing over excessive workload that we are taking on ourselves, which is not letting us focus on the things that will bring us joy. Because there could be a resentment which might happen if we are taking on something that is not truly contributing to our growth here. And the body-mind connection is highlighted here, meaning that if you're happy with what you're doing at work, you will see that reflect in your health. The connection between how we think about life, how happy, fulfilled we are mentally, and how that physically manifests in our health, that connection is made very strong and emphasized with Pluto, Saturn, and South Node in your house of mind-body connection. There is a deeper connection that exists. So if there are any health issues, if I may, I'm sorry to say there are sometimes health issues because it's a full moon. It highlights that there is a weakness in something in our body and that weakness is exaggerated during this eclipse. So because only when it pains, we fix it, right? So that pains a little bit to highlight either pains in the bone or pains in the ligament. Something pains to highlight that we are doing too much. That our future interaction with our own body needs to be in a more positive light. That we need to be more nurturing to ourselves. As we are servicing others, as we are servicing our job, as we are servicing our daily duties with a lot of responsibility, which you naturally do, we need to service our body as well. And at that point in time, with that thought in mind, with that appreciation of yourself in mind, you release the things, the toxins in your environment, in the diet, in your daily routines that needs to be released for you to achieve that. And that happens, in my view, as a precursor to your new moon, which is happening on 31st of July, which starts a new positive phase for you, which excites you, which amps you up, which sets you up for a new direction in life. A detox, a purge of sorts, which is not a regular purge. You will see it in the intensity of the environment itself right now. This is not a normal purge. This is a once in a lifetime purge which is happening right now. And the purge is of all the negativity, all the reasons that are holding us back, so we can be propelled at a speed like never before. You are creating a path on which you can go full blazing forward without any hindrance, without any fears, without any hiccups anymore. And this intensity and conviction with which you will pursue your goals, you will be unstoppable in that path. But at this point in time, for a brief moment, we are being asked to make sure that we are letting go whatever is stopping us. So we might be requested in some ways to take a step back in the coming days. And I think you should choose to do that in the coming days, because there are certain things that need to end. There are certain patterns that need to end. There are certain emotional patterns that need to change. And at the same time, we need to set up a self-care routine that serves us well moving forward, because this is the last phase of our personal enrichment. So Saturn, Pluto and South Node, they're in the sixth house. This is the last personal house before we move out in the world and be all we want to be. So in this last cadent or growth house, we work on ourselves behind the scene before the full reveal, before interacting with the world in a different way. And you will see some amount of closures come in at this point in time in the coming days, especially in the week of 16th of July. This week, essentially, we will see a few things which are coming to light for an easy closure. This could be health patterns. This could be work projects. This could be a work environment which we feel has served its karma, has served its purpose in our life. And now we want to move to a bigger thing. We want to move to a different thing now. We want to do something that gives us more excitement in life. And you could, at this stage, decide to even leave a mindset, because this is a regeneration of who you are as a person. You're defining the boundaries which did not exist before. And this is, if you imagine this from a work environment perspective or how you're operating at work, this is like you creating the rules of the game on how people should interact with you at work, what should and should not affect you in your work environment. You are creating a new protocol of operation when it comes to your work routine, when it comes to your co-workers, when it comes to the people who are working directly under you, and you're restructuring your health routine as well as a part of this eclipse. And it will feel very fated. It will feel that it's time. It will feel like it's popping, like it's right time to end something and move forward. And this closure leaves you with excitement. It leaves you with a revival. It leaves you with a regeneration that comes in the coming days. Especially after, I would say around 21st of July, there is a conviction. There's a conviction, a decision in your mind on what you want to do. And this is especially true if you have planets around 21, 22 degree. In fact, the whole 17 degree to 21 degree is, in my view, the most intent shifts happening. The most intentional shifts are happening from around 16th or 17th degree of Leo all the way till 24 degree of Leo, which is around till about 17th of August. So from 9th of August all the way till 17th of August, I would say, you would feel this very strongly. And after that, comes your season. After this moment of clarity on 21st of July on how you want to move forward, what needs to be released, what is done, how do we move forward, then comes your season from 22nd of July, and we have excitement in the air right off the bat with it. On 23rd, 24th of July, we have a grand fire trine in your sign with Mars in your sign. You're excited, you're ready to go. You feel it in your bones that you know which direction to take. It's exciting. It's about having the right kind of ambition, the right kind of path laid in front of you. After 23rd, 24th, 25th of July, you feel a reset come through. You feel a reset, a peace coming through within yourself. Just take a few days in my view off, or just take a step back in the coming days if you can, because this is an important exercise to understand. Even if you are at work, switch off a little bit from the intensity of the situation to see what are the elements that are working for you, what are not, when it comes to your work environment, when it comes to your health. And you will find the avenues to move forward from it. Because this is a supportive energy. This is an energy that is ready to happen, that is ready to manifest, where the, as they say, the event has already happened, but now we are acknowledging that event. So the change to some extent, the shift to some extent, has mentally already happened. Now we are going to see a physical manifestation of that. This grand fire trine, which is happening on 23rd or 24th, 25th of July, is happening around 14 or 15 degree of Leo. So if you're born around 7th of August, I would use that day to act, to do something future oriented, taking some risk in life, taking a leap of faith at the time, doing something that brings joy to you. Because the activities which are done on those dates, they are very lucky, if I can use that phrase over here, because Mars and Jupiter together is all about manifesting what you love, acting on things that bring you joy, and they happen. Jupiter is the planet of expansion. Mars is action. Both together, expanded action is happening with belief, with positive intentions, with a lot of faith in your heart. And that results in manifestation in a very positive fashion. It could be an investment risk. It would be a decision to sort of go in a direction that brings you more joy. Mars is in your sign right now. That happens once in 2 years. So every 2 years, the planet of action comes into our sign. And it amps us up to work towards what we truly want to create. Our desires and how we want to sort of act on those desires, that is amped up right now. There will be a little bit of moderation that will be called for, and you will experience that around 26th of July, when we have Mars and Saturn in conjunction. So you will be asked to, maybe you'll see that, you know, I need to be structured about this. I want this new start. I feel amped about it. But maybe I want to be a little bit aware of that there are certain structures, there are certain restrictions that I need to follow. And it's just about making sure that we are working within a protocol. And with that comes the Taurus moon. Taurus moon charges you up. It sort of, you know, it gives you an amp when it comes to your work. It's a fix it energy. Let's fix it. I've decided where I want to go. I've set some goals for myself around 23rd, 24th, 25th of July. Now let's act on it. Let's work towards that. So you'll be very charged up 25th, 26th, 27th of July in my view. And towards the end of the month, Chiron and Sun are together. You're healing your old wounds and moving forward here. Whatever has happened in the past is past. We move forward to a completely different future here. Especially July born might be making a shift in my view. Or if you're an early degree Leo, which is around 6 degree or 8 degree. So the first 10 degree of Leo, especially around 6 or 8 degree of Leo, which is around 30th of July born, 1st of August born, you might decide to change your job, your career at this point in time. And that comes with a new start in your career, new start in what you want to be or who you want to be known as, how you come across to the world, who you come across as. Because Uranus is in your house of career, you're looking for more excitement in your career. You're looking at adding more innovation in the work you do. And if you don't have that in your current job, you would look to shift that. And with that, your critical axis will be activated in August, which makes August the time of critical changes for you. When it comes to your work, when it comes to your partnerships and relationships. So certain decisions are made there. A new contract, a new job, releasing the old job, moving to a new one. This is especially true if your planet's around 6 or 8 degree of Leo, as I mentioned, which is around 30th of July or 1st of August born. Then a completion of contract or even a relationship, a contract, business contract or a relationship could happen around middle of August for people who you have planets around 22 degree of Leo, which is around 15th of August born, couple of 2 or 3 degrees before or after. So 13th of August to 17th or 18th of August might experience that come around middle of August. So we are working towards all of that. Why I'm telling you what's in store for August in your season is because the completions and the things that are coming to fruition, the things that are coming to completion right now with the eclipse that is happening on 16th of July has got everything to do with it. It is the time where we are required to heal ourselves, where we are required to pay attention to what our body is telling us, what we are being told about delegating things at work. Is there a structural change we need in work? Is there something that has given you fruits? This is not an eclipse where we just sort of are deciding about the future. The past is coming to a completion here. So some project might be recognized for some recognition at work for the work done in the past might come through. But all of that is about letting go. It's about releasing something. It's about deciding that is done with. Now I want to look at something else. Now I want to move forward with something which is different in structure. This is an eclipse of change in structure, and we'll see that in the coming weeks in terms of our governance system, in terms of how we handle our earthly resources in the world. There is a world, political shifts which will come as a result of this eclipse over the coming months. And this eclipse is a very potent eclipse in line of that. The authority of life changes. The structural changes at job, the structural changes at work, structural changes in administrations will be seen as a result of this. I spoke about it in detail in the part one of the video in terms of what are the global events which can happen as a result of that. But overall, being careful in health when it comes to your ligaments, when it comes to bones, because the eclipse is testing the structure of our life. It is testing the structure of our health. It is testing the structure by which we base our service, the service that we provide our job, the service that we provide to our family, the service that we provide to our body. So that element of service is being tested, and the balance between how well are you servicing yourself versus servicing others also comes into play here, and you will see a pull and a push here. So when you want to take some time off, you want to travel, you want to take a rest, something at work, something with respect to parents at home, something related to your co-workers, something related to the people who are working for you, that pulls you in the other direction and you're asked to make a choice. The road to success, as I mentioned, is self-care here, because you cannot help somebody else without you taking care of you. But at the same time, there is a karma that you're paying off when it comes to elders in your life, when it comes to your work, when it comes to your work routines to some extent. But while you're doing that, you're releasing certain fears of emotional pain, certain fears of being vulnerable in a situation, being vulnerable and open about certain situations where you need your space. where you need self-care. Sort of openly accepting that you need time. You need time for you. You need time to do the kind of things that you want to do. Also, the new moon that happened at the start of the month on 2nd of July, which will give us full fruits towards the end of this year, around 29th of October, was also about discovering new ways of doing things, certain hidden talents. So this might be the time over the course of next couple of weeks, or you might have already had an epiphany that something comes to light that I liked doing this. My emotions take me to that direction. It makes me happy if I do that. So certain hidden talents, certain hidden God-given gifts can come to light as well, which might work to that is in line of your self-care. That is in line of you taking care of what God has given you, whether it's your body or it's your talents. So, but that can only come about if you take a little bit of time away from being very busy at work I know it's not a popular notion, but just checking out even for a few hours away from people demanding your attention at this point in time. So good luck for that, Leo. I'll see you in your season now. Happy birthday again to Leo Sun, who are born in July. And we'll talk about your season in detail. Everybody is excited about Leo season because your season brings about happiness. It brings about joy. It brings about the sun. It brings about the light that we look forward to. So I'm really looking forward to your season. And we have a lot of manifestation energy in your season when new things start. Flowers completely come to bloom, right, in your season. And that's where we start seeing the results of all the work we have done behind the scene. So looking forward to that, and I'll see you in the August video now. Thank you.